The story of a quick biography of Sa'eed Al-Musayyib, and this is a story that, subhanAllah, I remember my teacher told me long time ago, told us long time ago, and I thought it just, inshallah ta'ala, it's interesting to share, because my teacher used to read some biographies of the Salaf to us after the lessons. So, yani, a quick, from what I remember off the top of my head, is that Sa'eed Al-Musayyib, rahimahullah ta'ala, if you guys know him, he's known as, maybe from amongst the scholars, they say he is Sayyid al-Tabi'een, the leader of the Tabi'een. Some of them say he was the best of the Tabi'een. The best of the Tabi'een. And there's others, they say, no, it was Uwais al-Qarni and then Sa'eed al-Musayyib. Uwais al-Qarni was the one who the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Umar al-Khattab, when you see him, ask Allah to forgive you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling Umar, the companion, to ask Uwais al-Qarni, the Tabi'i, student of the companion, to ask Allah to forgive you, because of the fact that he looked after his parents. Alayhal, Sa'eed ibn Musayyib was from the Imams of Al-Madinah. Rather, if you guys understand and you can research, if you guys know, the Fuqaha al-Sab'ah, the seven scholars of Al-Madinah. From amongst them were Sa'eed ibn Musayyib. His grandfather was from the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also his father as well. And his grandfather's name was Hazm. And so he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asked him, what's your name? He said, I am Hazm, which means hard, harsh. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as was his norm, he would change bad names. So he said, "Bal anta sahal, you're easy, you're lenient." So he said, "I'm not going to change a name that my father gave to me." So Sa'eed ibn Musayyib, he said, "From that time, my family have always had strict and harshness. We're always strict in our family. From that time, that's as a punishment for not changing the name the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave to him." And so Sa'eed ibn Musayyib, he died in the year 95, and he narrated from Abu Hurairah. And rather, he married the daughter of Abu Huraira. He married the daughter of Abu Huraira. And he narrated from Abu Huraira. And he took knowledge from Umar ibn al-Khattab and Ibn Umar and Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, radiallahu anhum, and Jabir ibn Abdullah, and many different companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rather, they used to say that he used to give fatwa in Medina whilst the companions were still alive. From amongst the Salaf, they said, Wallahi, innahu ahad al-Muftin. Wallahi, he is from the Muftin. He's a Mufti. He's a person who deserves to give fatwa. At a time, he was someone who no one would give fatwa in Al-Madinah whilst he was there. Or in talaq, in marriage law. He would never give, no one would give fatwa other than him. And today, everyone gives fatwa. Allahumma sta'an, Allahumma sta'an. Nasallahu salam wa al-afiyah. And so, one of the stories that came, that was really interesting in his biography that Al-Dhahabi mentions in the Sirah Alam al-Nubala, he says that one time, Sa'eed ibn Musayyib was in his class, and he noticed that one of his students from Quraysh, he was a Qurayshi student, he said that he never attended the class for a period of time. And so after a period of time, when he saw him, he said, where were you? So the man, he said, I was burying my wife. My wife just died and I was burying my wife and now I came back to the class. So Sa'eed, he said, did you get married again? Are you gonna get married again? So the man said, "Man yuzawwijuni? Who's going to marry me? And I have no money, no wealth, nothing." And he said, Sa'eed ibn Musayyib, he said, I will marry off my daughter to you. And this daughter was a daughter who Abdul Malik ibn Marwan, the Khalifa, asked for her hand. The leader of the Muslims asked for her hand for his son. And the Khalifa saying to his son, get married to this woman. And Sa'eed rejected. But he's marrying off a student to his student. And so he said, "Man yuzawwijuni? Who would marry me off?" He said, "I will marry you off." He said, "I don't have anything other than 2 dirham, 2 silver coins. How much is a silver coin worth? Around 1 pound, 2 pounds, something like that. He said, I only have 2 silver coins. That's all I have. I don't have anything else. He said, I have married you off to my daughter for 2 silver coins. And so he married her off for that money. And so the man, he went back home. When he went back home, he was fasting. And the student, he was fasting. And he said, I had my bread and my oil. They used to eat bread and oil. Bread and dip it in oil and eat it. That's what they used to do in a situation, you know, students. So he ate his bread and his oil. And then he heard a knock on the door. And so he put his food down. And he went to the door and he said, who is it? He said, Sa'eed. The man said, Sa'eed. So the man said, every Sa'eed came to my mind. Then I said, Sa'eed who? He said, Sa'eed ibn Musayyib. So he said, every Sa'eed came to my mind other than Sa'eed ibn Musayyib, because he was never seen for 40 years except between the masjid and his house. 40 years, he was never seen anywhere other than the masjid and his house. So he said, he is the last person that came to my mind. So he opened the door and he welcomed him, and behind him was his daughter. And so he said, after saying salam, he said, "This is your wife," and put her into the door. And so they closed the door. When they closed the door, she fell down out of shyness. And so he got his foot and he moved the oil to the side, into the shade, away from the lamp, because it was eating. So he said, "Wait here." And he came outside the house, went onto his roof, started throwing rocks to the next door neighbor, saying, "I've just got married. Give me something, this and that, give me something." And so his mother found out that he just got married. And so the mother said, "Wallahi, my face to your face is haram. Until you give her to me for 3 days, I will look after her and fix her up, and then I'll give her back to you for 3 days." So he gave it for 3 days and came back. And one day he was going out. He wanted it after the marriage period, the first period, when he stayed at home for a long time. Stayed at home with her. And he wanted to go out and leave the house to go and to the lesson of his teacher, Sa’eed Ibn Al-Musayyib. And so she grabbed him and said, "Where are you going?" He said, "I am going to the lesson of Sa’eed Ibn Al-Musayyib." He said, "Sit down, because I will teach you all of the knowledge of Sa’eed. And I have learned all of his knowledge." When he went to Sa’eed eventually, Sa’eed said, "Kayfa wajadta ahlak?" Or, "How did you find that girl?" He didn't say your family, sorry. "How did you find that girl?" The daughter. So the man said, "Wallahi, I never saw anyone more knowing of halal and haram, more knowledgeable of halal and haram, and more worshipping of Allah, and more knowledgeable of the rights of the husband, and more beautiful than the person that you gave to me, your daughter." And so Sa’eed said, he laughed, and he said, "If she does anything, then use your hand." Wallahu musta'an. Wallahu musta'an. And so, that shows the way of the Salaf. Sa’eed al-Musayyib, rahimahullah ta'ala, died in the year 95. That shows a great level of tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it shows a respect, or it shows who a person will marry their daughter of. And notice this is the granddaughter of Abu Huraira. And the one who, Abdul Malik ibn Marwan, the Khalifa, asked for his hand, for her hand. And he rejected because of a person who is righteous. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us to marry off those people who are, marry our daughters to those who are righteous and close to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والله أعلم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والحمد لله رب العالمين.